Amen. That was a hymn lead me to Calvary. Amen. It was a real precious to me. I love it. Although I don't know it all, I know all the words, but not how to sing it. We just want to welcome you this morning to the Great I Am Temple from wherever you are. This is our first Sunday. And listen, we've not been able to have our communion in-house since the pandemic. And we've just been waiting to move at the time that God would allow us to move and how to administer communion to the people of God, to our church family, and to you, and to lead you through. So we're just happy to be here. We're coming from our home. Amen. 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 So listen, I know how to have church at home. We wake up having church. I wake up having church at home, probably getting on everybody's nerves. But we want to go ahead and make sure that you have tuned in. If you're with us, we want you to post it. I'm trying to figure out which device I can look at so I can see you and know that you are with us today. So we're just going to go ahead and move right along. And as I said, I'm Pastor Clarissa. This is Pastor Jerome, our lead pastor, and this is our sister-in-law, amen, a member of the church. It's Sister Barbara Cooper, and we're here as a family. We have encouraged you to get up this morning, to get your families together, to get your representation of the blood and the body of Christ, and go along with us in this communion service this morning. Again, it's a little awkward because we're not in the sanctuary. But we're going to get through this because as often as we do this, we remember Jesus Christ and his goodness, his love, his sacrifice, man, even the fact that he is our intercessor every day. He is sitting on that throne interceding for us, and we are so grateful. So listen, I really have had my church this morning. I really have had my church this morning. I have just been praising the Lord. The atmosphere is set. It seems that the atmosphere is just right, and the season is just right to honor God in this way. So I want to read our scripture this morning, and it's coming from Isaiah, the 53rd chapter. I'm going to read verses 1 through 5. Who has believed our message, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? Mm-hmm. He grew up before him like a tender shoot and like a root out of dry ground. He had no beauty or majesty to attract us to him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and familiar with suffering. Like one from whom men hide their faces, he was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows. Yet we considered him stricken by God, smitten by him. Amen. Surely he took up our infirmities and carried our sorrows, yet we consider him stricken by God, smitten by him, and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgressions. He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon him. And by his wounds, we are healed. Amen. 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 And so we're just going to offer up a word of prayer at this time. Father God, we thank you for being an awesome God, for being wonderful, for being king, for being creator, for being all-knowing, all-seeing, everlasting, ever-loving. God, you're everything. You're El Shaddai, you're Elohim, you're Jehovah Jireh. Father God, you are way out of no way. You are a wheel in the middle of a wheel. You're our lily in the valley. You're our rose of Sharon. Father God, you are everything that we need. You're our hope, Father God, in hopeless situations. Father God, you're our help in helpless situations. Father God, you are everything. You are our joy in sorrow, Father God. Yeah. Father God, without you, Father God, we wouldn't even exist today. And Father God, we couldn't exist had you not taking care of us from day to day. And we honor you this morning, Father God. Father, we thank you for your son that you sent to Calvary today. God, we're most grateful. Oh, Father God, because we were in our sin, Father God. We were disobedient, Father God. We were not listening. We were falling by the wayside, full of all type of evil schemes, evil devices. Oh, God, our hearts were impure, Father God. Our minds have been torn up. But, Father, you sent your only begotten son to the cross, that he might be nailed there, Father God, a representative of Father God, that he would take on, Father God, all of our sins, Father God, the sins of this world, Father God, and that he would die, Father God, and then he would get up with victory, Father God. Yeah. And when he got up, we got up. So we thank you this morning, and we say hallelujah, Father God. We don't know anyone else that could be better to us, oh, Father God, than you have been to us in this hour. So, God, we thank you. We lift our hands and magnify your name because you are so worthy, Father God. There is none like you, nobody else who's worthy of the glory, and no one else who's worthy, oh, God, of the praise. We pray, oh, Father God, that you would be with us, Father God, as we move forward in this service, Father God, as we worship and honor you, Father God, in the only way, Father God, that we know how, because you have instructed us to do so and to do it often, Father God. We thank you now. In Jesus' name I pray, amen and amen. Amen. Come on, y'all put y'all hands together, amen, and bless the Lord. Amen in this home. Amen. We are just going to move forward. Listen, before we go forward, we want to say hello to all of our church members out there. We want to get this out of the way so Pastor can have his way. The Lord can have his way even here, even now. We want to say hello to the Great I Am family. We want to say hello to all of you that have tuned in with us even right now, or you're going to tune in later. Listen, this has been a tough week, amen, but it's been a tough 2020 for us as his people. But listen, I'm encouraged that we're going to make it, and we're going to make it with the Lord on our side. We have lost our niece this week. We have those who are sick and shut in, had some situations going on. But listen, we just read the scripture that by his stripes we are healed. So I want to make those announcements to you and appeal that we are, let you know that we are continuously praying for you, and we want you to continuously pray for us and our family. Amen. Amen. I also want to let you know that right up front, because I don't know how we're going to, you know, go, but I want to let you know ways to give and to be a blessing to the ministry. I also want to let you know that we are thankful for you tuning in last Sunday. Last Sunday was a good Sunday. Amen. It was a pastor's appreciation. And listen, we felt appreciated. And most of all, it's this pandemic way that we were appreciated. And I tell you what, we can't thank the members enough, and for our friends, for the tributes, for the dinner that we had. We can't show y'all the dinner pictures. We're not showing y'all the dinner pictures. But listen, we had a really, really good time. And then we had the virtual service. So we are, again, we just want to make sure that you know that we are grateful for that, for everything that you've done. Amen. With that being said, I want to go on and move on. I've got some, going to go a little bit different. We're going to do a little worship, but I found some hymns that I truly, truly love. And we open up with Lead Me to Calvary. And I just want to sing a medley. And you guys, if y'all know this and you're at your home, pick up and sing right along with us. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, favorite. And listen, I'm doing this a little bit different. I know we could have been very, very contemporary, but this blessed me this morning. I wanted to share it at the cross.
Alas, and did my Savior bleed, and did my Sovereign die? Would he devote that sacred head for sinners such as I? At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Was it for crimes that I had done? He groaned upon the tree. Amazing pit, grace unknown, and love beyond degree. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, mine. I hide my blushing face while his dear cross appears. Desire my heart in thankfulness and melt my eyes to tears. At the cross, say I'm where I first saw the light.
Some of these, were you there when they crucified? I like this, amen. One more. Thank you, Jesus.
Word.
Come on, anybody feel like magnifying Him? Thank you, Lord. Come on, I just want you to shout glory. Just go right ahead and post that glory. He rose from the dead. Amen.
Amen. Now I'm going to give it to our pastor.
Amen. We praise the Lord. We thank God for just another day's journey. Thank you, John, in advance for His grace and for His mercy.
Yes.
First, we want to say good morning to each and every one of you that are tuning in this morning. And as we always say, that has made the wake-up call. It's only because of His grace and His mercy that we live, we move, and we have our being.
Yes.
So for all the things that you have endured on this week, that ought to be enough right there to tell the Lord, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you for Him being who He is. Thank you for the activities of your limbs. Thank you for eyes to see, hands to wave, feet to stand on, a breath to breathe, and a mouth to talk, ears to hear. If it wasn't for the Lord who was on our side. Amen. Some of us would have given up. Some of us would have quit. The scripture says, thanks be unto God, who always calls us to triumph.
Come on now.
We're winning, preached one time, we're winning even with bad hands. Some of us have been dealt bad hands.
All right now.
Some of us have been through things that we think were unnecessary. But the scripture for that says that all things work for the good of those that love the Lord and for a call. Amen. So if you still here and if you still fighting a good fight of faith, amen, it's going to work out, amen. I don't know when, I can't tell you where, I can't tell you what month, I can't tell you what day, I can't tell you where you're going to be at when it happens, but it's going to happen, amen. It's by faith, amen, amen. It's all by faith, so we just have to have the faith as of a grain of a mustard seed, and believe and declare that God's word is true, and everything else is a lie,
amen.
That has to be our testimony,
amen.
When we don't feel like testifying, we don't look like we should testify, amen. But we have to remember that we can't get caught up in our feelings. Amen. We have to get caught up in our faith. Amen. So with that being said, we are just excited and delighted to be able to say a few words on today. Such an incredibly beautiful day outside. Amen. Another day that the Lord has made. If I could sing that song, I'm glad about it. Amen.
Amen.
So begin to get your... I'm not going to say begin, because when we woke up this morning, our mind should have been on Him. But if your mind is not on Him, just begin to think of the goodness of the Lord and everything that He has done. Amen. Everything He's doing. Amen. All the good and great things that He's done in your life. Amen. Focus on that. Amen. And you'll begin to feel better, think better, and act better. Amen. So we're just excited again about what He's doing. I ran across these words of comfort. I want to read it to you. Then I'm going to talk just a quick, short bit. Amen. Then we're going to go into our communion this morning. But I was kind of wondering, amen, in times like these, some of the things that people are experiencing. And this scripture here in 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter, I want to read you a little bit of that just to encourage someone's soul and someone's heart. Starting at the 7th verse in 2 Corinthians, the 4th chapter says, "But we have treasures in earthen vessels that our excellency of the power may be of God and not of us." It says that we are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus. That the life also of Jesus may be made manifest in our body.
Yes.
For we which live are away delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then, death worketh in us, but life in you.
Yes.
And I went to another reading of that being troubled and distressed. It says that we often suffer, but we are never crushed. Mm-hmm. Amen. Mm-hmm. Even when we don't know what to do, we can never give up. So I just want to encourage someone out there today. We don't understand, but never give up. Giving up is not an option. It's not the thing that we should do. Amen. This has been a extraordinary, difficult year. Amen. But on the same time, it's been a good year. Amen. Amen. It's like that charge. Dickinson's reading, these are the worst of times, but they are the best of times.
Okay.
Amen.
Go ahead.
You have to be able to locate and see some good.
Yes.
Even when it don't look good.
I like it.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Because I found out in early in life, my mother would make cakes and they would break up and fall apart.
Okay.
Yeah, I work with me right
there.
I can work
with you.
And she would be so disappointed because she had put so much into it, and it would just bust and fall apart, and it didn't look good.
Come on now. Yeah.
But when she moved that over to the side,
come on, I got you.
And I just needed a little bit of ice and a little bit of something on it, it was still good.
It was still good. Come on.
It may not have been presentable to win a beauty contest.
Come on now.
Amen. But it was good for the soul.
It was good for the soul.
So
Come on now.
I want to encourage someone to let you know that all things.
Yes. Come on now.
Amen. Even the good, the bad, the ugly, the hurt, the pain, the this, all that stuff is being mixed up. And it's all working for the good.
Yes.
So
yes.
Enjoy the ride.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Enjoy the ride. Don't get halfway there and turn around. Amen.
I see. Enjoy the ride. Yes.
Amen. This journey that we're on. Amen. Somebody wrote a song. Nobody told me
that it was wrong with me.
Yes, sir.
Come on now.
But I don't believe.
Yeah. Come on. He brought me this far.
I'm going to preach up in here anymore.
Yeah.
Amen. And it was him that brought you this far.
Yeah.
And if he's able to bring you this far,
come on.
Somebody say surely out there.
Surely.
Surely he's able to finish what he started.
Yeah.
Amen. 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 He's able to finish what he started. Amen. Amen. We just have to keep the faith. Amen.
Yes.
We just have to keep on. I tell them all the time at work, keep getting up.
Yeah.
Just keep getting up.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You get knocked down, keep getting up.
Keep getting up.
You get hurt, keep getting up.
Keep getting up.
You get behind, keep getting up. Amen. You want to get funny, keep getting up.
Come on, preacher.
Amen. Just keep getting up.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. Because he told us in the scripture that the race is not given to the front runner. Amen.
Come on now.
It's not given to the front runners. Amen. Yeah. It's not given to the person that look like they're going to win.
Uh-huh.
It's not given to the person that appears to look like they're going to win.
On,
but you've got to be able to take some stuff.
Oh, yeah.
That's what he says, that those that may endure to the end. Amen.
Yes.
And coming in first, amen, the first place winner is not always the winner. Amen.
Uh-oh.
Everybody that participates in a race, especially in this day and time, they get a prize.
Okay.
First place.
Uh-huh.
Second place. Hey, come on, talk about it. Third place. But it don't make any difference what place you come in. Amen.
As long as you come in.
You got to come in. Just talk to the finish line. Amen. Just dip your head like the cross finish line out there. Just dip your head. Amen. 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 Yeah. You are winning this thing. Amen. Even with the bad hand that you dealt yourself. Come on, you know when you're playing cards. I'm not sorry. You know when you're playing cards. Sometimes you deal yourself
a
bad hand.
A bad hand.
Amen. And in this day and time, you can't throw it back.
Uh-huh.
Amen. You got to deal with it. Amen.
Deal with it.
Just deal with you have, amen. Yeah. And you never know how this thing is going to work out in your life, amen.
Yes.
Amen. Yes. We are all trying to get there.
Yes.
Somebody may ask, well, where am I trying to get there?
Come on.
I'm trying to get to where he is.
Okay.
Amen. Yes. And if he struggled, if he suffered, and if he went through, if he had some disappointment, if he had some people turn their back on him, if he had some people walk away from him, if he had to go through by himself, amen.
Yes.
If he had to call upon the name of his father,
amen,
that means we have to do the same thing. Must I bear the cross?